center of just query was the Days of Glory March by John Cactus. Variations on a Korean folk song by John Barnes Chance is probably one of the most unusual pieces of band literature that has ever been written. The many oriental effects produced by the temple clocks, the gong, and the cymbals, plus the Korean theme itself, gives the listener the most authentic taste of the Orient. And be aware in the title that it says variations, because there are six in all. The first is rather slow and somber. The second, light and fast. The third, slow and melancholy. The fourth, march-like. The fifth, slow again, but with a rhythm of pulse that's produced by the timpani. And finally, the sixth is fast and impetuous. Ladies and gentlemen, we're very happy to present the Aquinas Institute concert band, conducted by Mr. Fabrizio, and the magnificent, exciting variations on a Korean folk song.
Thank you.
So at this particular time, I'd like to call upon one of our seniors. 4 years ago, this little boy came to Aquinas and joined the band. During the course of these 4 years, he had been a member of the marching band and the concert band. And today, we thought that we'd give him an opportunity, the last time that he would be appearing on the stage in a Aquinas concert, to perform a drum solo. So, ladies and gentlemen, Dave Kudensky. Thank you. arrangements he calls Swing Tonic. Many of you are going to recognize the tune when you hear it. He took the familiar Lumberjack air, which we know as Daddy Boy, and he made it into the big band sound that so many of us are familiar with years ago. Now the Aquinas Institute band, Mr. Fabrizio, and Sammy Mestico's Swing Tonic.
And he transcribed it for the piano.
And then about 30 years later, he was playing in Russia when one of his friends, who happened to be the director of the Imperial Guard Band, said, "That's a very interesting piece. Where is, what is that?" And he told him what it was and where he heard it. And so he said, "Would you ever mind if I arranged it for the band?" And so Mr. Rachmaninoff added some flourishes and fanfares to it. And today we have the Italian polka from Russia through Mr. Goldman, and finally the Aquinas band and Mr. Fabrizio.
Thank you. concussion ward. Well, we do this for two reasons. First of all, I give the many concussionists we have a chance to perform. Plus, I'd like to show the people what they're paying for. Now, when these instruments up here are over the block this year, we'd like to show them off. First composition, the music box, which was written just for that purpose. It sounded exactly like the music box. And we're utilizing three instruments, the vibraphone, the orchestra bells, and the glockenspiel. I'm sure you just sit back and close your eyes and positive that the sound of the music box would hit you. The second composition, the spirit cell, utilizes two timpani, timbali, snare drum, and xylophone. And I found out just the other day that this composition written by Mr. Goodman, who is one of the principal percussionists in New York City, wrote it and dedicated it to one of his friends in the service. If you listen very closely in the center part of the composition, you'll hear a bugle call that most servicemen don't wish to hear in the morning. So we went through the music box and the stairs.
Thank you.
perhaps have been noticing the charming girls we have on our stage. Let me tell you a story. Not so long ago, the Atlantis band took a tour throughout New York State, performing in various public schools, one Catholic school, in various parts of the state. And I must admit that we were very proud of them. They did a marvelous job. And we got nothing but raves, not only from the teachers and the administration, but from the students themselves. But at the same time, there was always one focal point for the students, and that was the four girls, the three girls, rather, who accompanied us on that particular tour. Well, the girls thought that this was unfair, that it would be just three. So a few more have volunteered, and now we have a number of girls from Nazareth Academy who are performing with our band on these combined numbers. And for this reason, we'd like to thank very sincerely Sister Beverly, who has done such a marvelous job in the business department at Nazareth Academy. We're very proud to be cohorts with her in performing this evening. And also to Sister Annunciata, the principal of Nazareth Academy, for the wonderful cooperation that they have given so that both our boys and our girls may have this wonderful, valuable experience of playing music together. Once again, we call upon the artistry of Sammy Castillo, and the next composition you will hear is called Montego Bay. It's a samba, and you will notice, listen closely, or for those who advance the samba, that there is a very heavy feeling on the first and third beat of the measure. And this is what separates this kind of music, this kind of Latin rhythms, from all the rest. And the composer stated himself that this number should not be overpowering, but rather relaxing. So sit back and relax as you listen to Sammy Castillo's Montego Bay.
Thank you.
attempts to display the many techniques necessary to perform such difficult composition. We're very proud then to present our first chair trumpet player, Bill Carter, who will now play the famous Carnival of Venice.
Thank you.
TV, but anything less spectacular. Although not related to our beloved principal, who unfortunately could not be with us this evening because he is attending a meeting with the Brazilian Father Administrators, but still in all, I must say that the Hart family have been very much a part of the climate for the past 4 years. And Bill's mother, Mrs. Hart, was the chairman of this concert this evening. And Mr. Hart has held so many positions, from chairman of the dances to representative of the band boosters group at the PACE meetings to on and on and on, so that we are indeed very, very grateful to the Hart family for their contributions to the Aquinas family.
Thank you.
the Italian polka was arranged for band as a result of very interesting series of conversations and correspondence between the great Russian composer Sergei Rachmaninoff and an American by the name of Edmund Goldman. The story goes something like this. Mr. Rachmaninoff was visiting in Italy. One day he saw an old organ with these donkey-drawn organ riders going down the street, was playing a very interesting, fascinating polka. And that tune so intrigued him that he went back to his hotel and he transcribed it for the piano. And then about 30 years later, he was playing in Russia when one of his friends, who happened to be the director of the Imperial Guard Band, said, "That's a very interesting piece. What is that?" And he told him what it was and where he heard it. And so he said, "Would you ever mind if I arranged it for the band?" And so Mr. Rachmaninoff added some flourishes and fanfares to it. And today we have the Italian polka from Russia through Mr. Goldman. And finally, the Aquinas band and Mr. Fabrizio.
Thank you.
Clifford Clavier was one. One of the most progressive organ compositions of his time, it incorporated sounds never
thank you.
concerts in the past, I've not seen so much percussion there. Well, we do this for two reasons. First of all, I give the many percussionists we have a chance to perform. Plus, I'd like to show the people what they're paying for. Now, when these instruments up here are open to go off this year, we'd like to show them off. First composition, The Music Box, which was written just for that purpose, to sound exactly like The Music Box. And we're utilizing three instruments, the vibraphone, the arc, the bells, and the glockenspiel. I'm sure you can just sit back and close your eyes and positive that the sound of The Music Box will pitch it. The second composition, The Scherzo, utilizes two timpani, timbali, snare drum, and xylophone. And I found out just the other day that this composition, written by Mr. Goodman, who is one of the principal percussionists in New York City, wrote it and dedicated it to one of his friends in the service. If you listen very closely in the center part of the composition, you'll hear a bugle call that most servicemen don't wish to hear in the morning. So we're going to do The Music Box and The Scherzo.